We are going to understand first the acid and base reaction, which is also called as neutralization reaction. So now it is RA, neutralization reaction. Okay. So now we know that when acid reacts with base, they form salt and water. And this is nothing but the neutralization reaction. Okay. So just I'm writing the general reaction. Acids plus base equals to salt and water. Okay, so this is the general reaction. Now we have to write the description for that. So when acids reacts with base, they form salt and water. Okay, is called as neutralization reaction. Okay, now we will understand the example. Okay, suppose we have HCl, hydrochloric acid. When it is going to react with sodium hydroxide, NaOH, okay, they will form salt. So we have here Na and Cl, so we'll form NaCl, sodium chloride, and which is nothing but the salt, and that OH and H is going to combine to form water molecule. Okay, so here we have hydrochloric acid. Then we have sodium hydroxide. Which is the base. They form sodium chloride. Which is nothing but the salt and water. Okay, so this is the first acid-base reaction, and which is nothing but the neutralization reaction. So here we have the definition. Okay, here we have example. Take a screenshot, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now we will understand few more example by which you can understand the reaction properly. Everyone done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now this reaction is for you. I'm just going to write the part of it. Then you have to tell me which product we will write there. So first, again, next example, second one. This is the second. Now we have HNO3. It is a nitric acid. Then here we have the blank. Then the product is KNO3, it is potassium nitrate and water. So what will come in the blank space?
Sir, can I?
Yes.
Sir, here when there is only K, potassium, it will react to form KNO3.
Only potassium?
Sir, KNO?
No.
Sir, can I say
KOH?
Yes.
KOH.
Yes, potassium hydroxide. It is KOH. This potassium hydroxide. Okay. So here NO3 is going to combine with potassium. Okay, to form potassium nitrate, and that H going to react with OH to form H2O. Okay. So here I'm going to write the name. So it is nitric acid, it is potassium hydroxide, it is potassium nitrate, and water. you can write a description like for each reaction, like when nitric acid reacts with potassium hydroxide gives potassium nitrate and water. You can write description for each reaction. Okay, now next reaction, third reaction. Srija, you there beta? Srija?
Yes sir.
Okay, so you had to tell what will be come in the blank space. So here we have blank, then our next base will be twice of ammonium hydroxide. It is NH4OH, ammonium hydroxide, and in product we have ammonium sulfate. It is NH4 twice SO4. Again we have the blank. So what will come over here and here? What will come, beta?
H2SO4 and H2O.
Yes, yes. Here will come H2SO4. It is sulfuric acid, and here water molecule. Good. Okay. So now we have to write the name of the reactants and product. So it is sulfuric acid.
Sir.
Yes.
I'm not understanding, sir. How are you determining the chemicals so fast?
Okay. See, here we have ammonium, which comes from here. Okay. And we know one compound is definite and which is water. Okay. So what is new here? Here we have OH and here we have sulfate group SO4. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So we know that SO4 comes always from the sulfuric acid. Is it?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So that OH is going to form water. So here from H will be from that SO4. Okay, because H2SO4, when it is going to break down, will form H positive ion and SO4. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very simple. Okay. So you have to, like, we have like only few acids that they are taking into consideration in chemical reaction. Generally, we have hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid. Okay, and generally HBr, hydrogen bromide also. Okay. So now we have to write the name. Okay, so here we have sulfuric acid. Here we have ammonium hydroxide. It is ammonium hydroxide, beta. Ammonium hydroxide. Here we have ammonium sulfate. It is ammonium sulfate. And here we have water. Okay, now next is for Anudhi. Fourth example. Suppose we have acid blank, then it reacts with potassium hydroxide, this KOH. And the product will be, suppose we have KBr. And here again we have blank. So Anudhi, what will come in blank? Yes. Anudeep, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
What will come in blank? See, we know one product is fixed, which is H2O. So we have to write H2O here. Yes, H2O. And see, in H2O, H and OH we have. So OH, which is coming from the base. So what will remain here? H. And here we have Br, so product that reactant will be HBr, hydrogen bromide. Easy or very easy?
Very easy.
Yes, HBr. That's way we have to decide what will be in the blank. Okay?
Now I got it, sir.
Okay, so now we have to write the name of reactant and product now. So HBr is hydrobromic acid. You have to write hydrobromic acid. For KOH, we have potassium hydroxide. Then we have potassium bromide. And then we have water. Okay. So this is the way we have completed four examples in order to explain you how acid and base react to form salt and water. So take a screenshot, everyone.
Yes, sir. Done.
Done, sir.
Now we are going to discuss the reaction of acids with metal. So again, I am going to give you the general reaction by which you can write a reaction on the basis of the valency of metal. Okay. So let me write first the general reaction. We have like when metals reacts with dilute acid or acid, I'm writing only acid, they gives salt, metallic salt. So I have to write metallic salt.
So what is metallic salt?
Wait a second, I'll explain a bit. Metallic salt. Suppose we have taken metal sodium and we have taken acid as HCl. So they are going to form sodium chloride, NaCl. Okay. So this is nothing but the salt, but here in salt we have metal. See, we are taking reaction for metal. That's why they are going to form metallic salt. Okay.
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay. So they are going to form metallic salt and hydrogen gas will release. Very important. Hydrogen gas will release. Okay. So this is the general reaction for reaction of acids with metal. So now I'm going to write description for that. So you can relate this description for each individual reaction. You can relate that.
What is this called, sir?
What? It is general reaction, beta.
No, it doesn't have a name like a neutralization reaction.
No. It is a metal reaction of metal with acid. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to write the description for the reaction. So when metals reacts with acids, they form metallic salt and hydrogen gas is released. Okay, example. Now we'll take some example. Suppose we have sodium that we have taken in example. Suppose we have sodium metal. When it is going to react with HCl, it is hydrochloric acid, will form NaCl, which is the sodium chloride, and hydrogen gas will release. So see, in order to release hydrogen gas, we will have to have two hydrogen atoms. But HCl is going to release only H, only one H. So we had to multiply here by two coefficient. Now we have balanced the hydrogen, but chlorine also get increased by one. So again, we had to multiply here by two in order to balance the chlorine. Now we have two sodium. So here we had to multiply by two coefficient. Now the reaction is balanced. Okay. So now we have to write the name of reactant as well as product. So here we have sodium metal. Sodium metal, it is hydrochloric acid. Then we have sodium chloride. and here we have hydrogen gas. Okay, you can write description for each individual reaction. This is the first reaction. Like when sodium reacts with hydrochloric acid, it is dilute one. Huh? Sodium is very reactive, it can react with dilute acid. So I am writing here DIL. DIL is for dilute acid. Okay, to form sodium chloride and hydrogen gas is released. Understood? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So now we are going to discuss the next reaction. Again, next reaction, we will, I'll ask question for it. This is for Prativa. Prativa, you there, beta?
Yes, sir.
So second reaction, I'm just making some blank spaces. So you have to fill that. Huh? Suppose we have zinc. Zinc, it is the metal. When it is going to react with acid, I'm not writing the which acid we are going to use, but they will form zinc sulfate. It is ZnSO4 along with hydrogen gas will release. So which acid will come over here, beta?
H2SO4. In question mark?
H2SO4.
Yes, H2SO4. Sulfuric acid. Here we have SO4 and here we have H2. So H2SO4 will be the answer. Anudeep, understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think you got the concept now.
Okay. Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay. So here we have zinc. We have sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid. Then we have zinc sulfate. And then we have hydrogen gas. So you can write description for this reaction. You have to write description for individual reaction whenever you are noting down on your notebook. Okay. So description will be for this reaction is when zinc reacts with sulfuric acid, gives zinc sulfate and hydrogen gas will release like this. Okay. Next is for Himanshu, this reaction is for you, beta. This reaction is for you, huh? Yes. So we have, I will give you both the blank over here. Okay. Both the places will be blank. And I'm just writing the product. So we have like copper nitrate. It is Cu in bracket. We have NO3 twice. And hydrogen gas will release. Okay, so what will be the reactants? So first blank and second blank. Yes. Himanshu.
One and see you with the
Himanshu. Who else we have? Ashish.
Yes, sir.
What will come in blank spaces, beta?
Sir, I think first one is Cu plus 2HNO3.
No, no. Only we had to write metal, so we had to write copper only, Cu.
Cu, yes, sir. Cu yes. Only, sir, first.
Yes. And here?
Second one is 2HNO3.
Yes, twice HNO3. Good. Okay, yes, very nice. Okay, so we had to write the name of reactants as well as product. So here we have copper. Then we have nitric acid. Then we have copper nitrate. The CO, copper nitrate, and then we have hydrogen gas. Very good, Himanshu. Okay, not Himanshu, it's Ashish, no? Ashish, yes. Okay, so I want you to like take a screenshot for that. Wait a second, let me zoom in. Now we are going to discuss about the reaction of acids with metal oxide. Okay, so see, in previous reaction we have reacted acid with metal. Is it acid with metal? There was no oxygen, but here we have metal along with oxygen. They are called as metal oxide. So when they will react with acid, they will form metallic salt and water, because here oxygen. So that oxygen is going to react with hydrogen to form water molecule. This is the only difference between reaction of metal and acid and metal oxide with acid. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the again general reaction. Okay, so in general reaction we have metallic oxide or metal oxide, we can write also metallic oxide plus, see, along with metallic oxide, okay, which is going to which one is going to react, acid or base? So acid, because we are just checking the reaction of acid only, acid. So they will form metallic salt along with water. And we know metallic oxides are basic in nature, so it is nothing but the kind of neutralization reaction only. Okay, so this is the general reaction beta. Now we have to write description for the reaction. So I'm writing here description. When metallic oxide reacts with acid gives, instead of gives we can write form or gives metallic salt and water. Okay, this is the description for the reaction. So now we have to check example. So I'm just writing first example over here. Suppose we have metallic salt, ferrous oxide. It is ferric oxide, Fe2O3. It is ferric oxide. When it is going to react with HCl, hydrochloric acid. Okay, so they will form ferric chloride. See, we have two ferrous. So it is going to form, a ferrous will form FeCl3. It is ferric chloride. But here we have two ferrous. So here we have to multiply by 2. Okay. Plus, see here we have total number of chlorine will be 3 into 2, means total 6. So here we have to multiply by 6 coefficient. So now here we have 3 oxygen. Here we have 3 oxygen and we have 6 hydrogen. So they will form 3H2O molecule. So we have to write 3H2O. So this is the balanced reaction for ferric oxide and hydrochloric acid. Understood everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now we have to write the name of reactants and products. So it is ferric oxide. Ferric oxide. It is hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid, it is ferric chloride, and water. Okay, so this is the first reaction. Now, again, the question answer session. The second reaction.
Sir, I'm studying through screenshots for exam. Is it okay? Sir, I'm studying through screenshots for exam. Is it okay? Or should I write it?
If not now, but after class, you can write because these are the very important reaction of your chapter. So you have to write each and every reaction accord with their description also. I am just
sir, writing. I'm studying through screenshots.
Okay. But if you will write on your notebook, so one time writing equals to three time reading.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So next reaction is for Sadab.
Yes, sir.
Suppose we have calcium oxide, beta. Calcium oxide, when it is going to react with HCl, hydrochloric acid, what will be the product?
Yes, sir.
Calcium chloride.
CaCl2 plus H2O.
Ca?
CaCl2 plus yes. H2O.
CaCl2 plus H2O, yes. Is it the reaction is balanced?
No, sir. We should add 2 before the HCl.
Yes.
CaO plus 2.
Multiply. Yes. We have to add 2 coefficient before the HCl. So now the reaction is balanced. Okay. So now we have to write the name. So it is calcium oxide. It is hydrochloric acid. See, every time if you are writing hydrochloric acid, that means HCl is in aqueous form. Don't forget that. It is aqueous form. Okay. This is calcium chloride. And water. Okay. Now we have next reaction is for Anudeep.
Yes, sir.
Yes, next reaction is for you. Suppose we have magnesium oxide, MgO. I'm writing here blank. Then here also blank. This is the reaction. And all the blank. Only you have MgO. What will be the reaction for MgO? Which acid we will use?
Sir, at the last one, it will be H2O.
Yes, it is H2O. Okay.
Then will it so is there chemical HMG or MGH?
MG? Sir, can I see?
Yes. What's your name?
Ashish, sir.
Ashish, yes, Ashish.
Sir, 2HCl.
2HCl.
MgO plus 2HCl.
Yes.
Gives rise to MgCl2.
Twice HCl. And they will form MgCl2. Yes, this is the balanced reaction also. Okay, so here we have magnesium oxide. Here we have hydrochloric acid. Here we have magnesium chloride. Then we have water. Okay, next reaction is for let me check. Tanvi.
Yes, sir.
This is for you. Next reaction, fourth one. Again we have MgO, same, but not HCl. Here we have blank and last we have H2O. So you have to fill the blank first and second. We should not take HCl. Yes, fill in the blank, beta.
H2SO4, so first blank.
Yes, H2SO4.
And the second blank is MgSO4.
Yes, MgSO4. Good, very good. Very good. Okay, understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Again, this is the magnesium oxide. Yes. Here we have sulfuric acid. Here we have magnesium sulfate. And water. Okay. Now, next reaction is for Tushar. Tushar being very, silenced today. Tushar?
Yes, sir.
We have ZnO beta, ZnO, zinc oxide. And it reacts with HCl. What will be the product? Yes.
Sir, ZnCl plus H2O.
Zn?
Cl.
ZnCl. We have valency of zinc is 2.
Yes, sir.
So?
ZnCl plus H2O.
Zn?
Cl plus H2O.
ZnCl. But it is going to be ZnCl2. And here we have to multiply by 2 coefficient before HCl. Now the reaction is balanced. Okay. So when zinc oxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, gives zinc chloride, it is ZnCl2. Because zinc have valency 2, chlorine have valency 1. So zinc will require 2 chlorine. Okay. So like here, we have zinc with valency 2 and chlorine with valency 1. So we will require 2 chlorine and 1 zinc. So it will be ZnCl2. And always we had to write the positive species followed by negative species. Even in name also, when we are writing the name, we are writing the name of positive species first and then negative species, zinc chloride. Okay, this standard is given by the IUPAC. You know what is IUPAC, no?
Yes, sir, it's an exam.
What is IUPAC?
So it's a competitive exam.
No. IUPAC.
IUPAC. I don't have a card.
It is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry or Chemist. It is a standardized, the system which is given by IUPAC for writing the name of organic and inorganic substance. We will understand for organic substance in your hydrogen like carbon containing compound. We'll study that IUPAC system. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Then here we have hydrochloric acid. Then we have zinc chloride and water. Okay. I think we had enough example. Or you want one more? One more or enough?
One more.
Okay. We'll have one more example. So it is 561. Suppose we have aluminum oxide. It is Al2O3. It is reacts with, suppose we have hydrogen fluoride, HF. Okay. So what will be the product?
Sir, what?
HF. HF hydro,
sir, means?
Hydrofluoric acid.
It's Cl now, sir.
No. Instead of Cl, we have taken fluorine.
So hydrofluorine acid.
Yes. We have halogen family. We have fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. We can take anyone. So I have taken fluorine. Okay. So it is hydrofluoric acid. It is aluminum oxide. Okay. So what will be the product? Akil. Akil is going to answer that. We know one product is confirmed and which is H2O. Yes, Akil.
Yes, sir.
What will be the product. One more that we have blank space here.
So maybe Al2F.
Al?
2F.
See, beta, aluminium have valency 2. See, yes. We have, wait a second. No. Aluminium have valency 3. And fluorine have valency 1. So we will have one aluminium and three fluorine. So the product will be ALF3. Product will be ALF3. But here we had two aluminium, no? So here we have to multiply by two coefficient. Now aluminium is balanced. But if we will multiply here by two coefficient, the number of fluorine will be 6. So here we had to write 6 fluorine. Now 6 hydrogen will release, so we'll form 3 water molecule. So we have to write here 3 coefficient. Now reaction is balanced. Okay.
Sir, what is ALF3 called?
It is aluminium fluoride. I'm writing the name also. Wait a second. It is aluminium fluoride and water. Okay. Okay, so wait a second. You have to take a screenshot for that.
Sir, generally would they use, sorry.
Amida?
Generally would they use fluorine those to balance or like in reactions?
Generally fluorine individual is not taken because it is very...
Even bromine.
Bromine, see. Take a screenshot, then I am going to explain you why we are not taking fluorine and bromine also. Okay, so take a screenshot first, then I'll explain that also.